struggling either.
Yeah.
You have the veteran benefits, right, Gunny?
What's that?
Veteran benefits, right?
I do. I'm 100% disabled vet. Yes.
Absolutely.
I want to point something out. While you rich?
What was the point of that question?
My point was you're not struggling. You worked in the military. You have retirement. You have benefits. So yeah, that's not the average person though.
Right. I want to point something out. While you rich Negroes are living in a lap of luxury, Ukrainians are getting their faces blown off. I just want to point that out real quick, just to let you guys know that there's a war in South Sudan brewing real quick right now. So I just want to point that out. So I don't know how African Americans are struggling compared to most people on the planet, but that's just me. Though. I just want to point that out.
Will with the $10 super chat. Hamp, you should do a show on the Supreme Court case against Harvard. A lot of the statistical metrics show that African Americans were being admitted with
that's
lower
true.
Credentials.
That is true. A lot of Asian American students had to score. Roller Skater Texas Girl, thank you so much for that $20 super chat. Thank you so much. A lot of Asian American students were being denied entry into the Ivies and you know, their standard, I think their score had to be like 1600 while African Americans would be 1200. I think that's injustice to Asians, if you ask me.
I would love to get more background on that because I think that's kind of propaganda. I don't
no,
know.
It's true. It's an actual court case.
What I'm saying is this. I just want to, because they can say that, and I just don't trust the elite, right, making the decision because they can sit there and get purposely go to certain demographic to get someone that they know won't succeed to prove their point on purpose. See, we let them in. They shouldn't come in here in the first place. But I want to know more about that study. So I kind of agree with that super chat. I might read up on it myself in my spare time because I don't believe. I think it was what's the word? I'm sleepy. What's the word? Bet against you. What's the word, y'all? Not bet against you, but help me. I feel like I'm on my own. When you purposely have what your narrative being supported, you'll purposely find someone.
Confirmation bias.
Like, say it one time, Hamp.
Confirmation bias.
Yes, I mean that's a part of it. It's confirmation bias. You'll purposely go out to find to throw the weight. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so you're saying potentially they let those people in so they can prove their point so they don't have to let them in anymore.
Exactly. That is what I'm saying. But there's a term for it, and I just couldn't think of it because I'm sleeping. I believe that's what happened. I don't just trust that they found a creme de la creme and they just failed. No.
Mm-mm. I never broached the clip that you showed with that black guy from the 70s. Chaotic Truth Live in the chat says Hamp drives a convertible BMW. I think that guy
six kids. Yeah, they don't drive no damn BMW.
I think that guy should be ashamed of himself. He's probably an old man now. If it were not for the white man, I gotta say this. He would be living in the Stone Age right now. White man, he came into Africa, he saw the Negro was living like biblical times, and he ushered in Western civilization. Alex drives a Maserati. She probably does. Exactly. And it is shameful, man, that we disrespect and dog Western society also. And that's what that black guy was doing in that clip. He's using the clippers that were made in America, probably. He drove to that barbershop in an American car, probably. He's in a building built by Americans. And he has the nerve to dog Western society. It's shameful. Even
built
in
by his ancestors. The building that was probably built by his ancestors.
Whether they were built by his ancestors or not.
His people.
Which may be true or not, but again, it's this disrespect of Western society that I just find mind-boggling.
I didn't think that was disrespect. I think that he was in that time, he said from the 70s, he was speaking not anecdotally, he was speaking his personal real life experience. And so, yeah, he's making it off, but it's true.
I bet you that Negro had a white wife. Keep it real.
But you can't prove it. Just like we can't prove that your wife's even black and is upstairs waiting for you. We again, more proof.
Ma'am, so, I live in a one-bedroom apartment. I don't have a upstairs. No, I'm black.
Back to my point. That man was speaking to his experience at that time. And he absolutely, everything he said was true and factual. He was saying, how can I trust you and trust this government when you have a history of lying? You have a history of backstabbing and betrayal. So I don't see anything he said was wrong. And you had that same old tired, you know, statements about driving an American car and he'd been in some mud hut in Africa. Like, those are so late and tired. You say the same things over and over again. I think you have a script. And I've been rocking with you tonight, though. But I'm just letting you know, you read from a script. But that man that was maybe have been left in Africa, he could have been successful too. But if that country and that, if that continent wasn't raped and pillaged, then you, who knows what could have come of the different nations there, number one. Number two, you can't, you literally, truthfully cannot deny that there's a history of betrayal, lies, and backstabbing. And everything I mentioned.
What's the betrayal?
The
compromise of 1877.
Thank you, Rotonda.
Okay, what was the compromise of 1877? What was it?
That's where the backdoor deal went after President Lincoln passed away, where they gave the moderate Democrats from the South, they freed them from their obligations in giving Black people their 60 acres.
Okay. Can I ask you a question then? Who did you vote for in the last two elections? Which side of the aisle?
I didn't vote the first okay. one, and the second one, I voted for Joe Biden.
Okay, who's a Democrat? Miss Risky, who did you vote for? What side of the aisle? Hold on for a second. What side of the aisle did you vote for?
So I read this super chat so I can get off the screen.
Gunny did well, $10. Yeah. Go ahead, you want to hear your voice. Yeah. Go ahead, Chaotic. You got it.
Gunny with the $10 super chat. Thank you so much. Says Hemp got 6 kids. He drives a Nissan. Sienna, super fan. Now, Miss Risky, I got to ask you a question too. You said that there was betrayal, and Roe mentioned the compromise of 1877, which was executed by the Democrats. I'm curious, who do you vote for in your local elections? Who do you vote for in your state?
Democrats election? Back then was a different population.
They were different. Why were they different?
They were different because they were Southern racist.
They were Southern racist.
Man,
I didn't know that.
The Republicans betrayed Black people in the compromise of 1877. That's a fact. Look it up. It's not on Democrats. It's on Republicans. Exactly. That's a fact. Mm-hmm.
That's
Republicans stab Black people in the back.
Exactly.
That's the truth.
As they usually
do. Can I ask you a question? Under which side of the aisle, according to history, which side of the aisle has done the most dirt to the quote-unquote Black Americans?
Democrats.
It's a fact.
Democrats. But we're talking about the compromise of 1877. That's Republicans stabbing Black people in the back. Let's make that clear.
That most of the criminal activity that is done in the government is done by Republicans, and they've broken that down per state.
So yes. Give me an example. Give me an example of when Republicans have done this to Black people.
Have done what have they done?
You said
they've
that Republicans
stolen money. They've stolen money.
When have they stolen money?
They've tried to steal votes. Let's talk about that.
Okay, when did they try to steal votes? The Republicans.
They tried to steal votes in the last election.
You mean the last election that was supposed to be in Fulton County? Okay, so you're telling me the last election. So that's funny. The Republicans tried to steal votes. But somehow the Senate and the White House are Democrat led. That's funny because the Republicans
I didn't say they were successful.
Yeah. What are you arguing? What are you arguing right now?
Because I'm trying to figure out if the Republicans are so bad, why is it that the Democrats run the House and run the Senate and run the White House?
Who stated that they were a Democrat?
Roe said that she voted for Democrats. I'm just, and she brought up the compromise of 1877 as a betrayal for blacks. And she's saying that the Democrats are different.
Chaotic. Why can't you just let her statement land? You asked her a question, she answered it.
Because her statement makes no sense. Again, you vote for the very same thing that quote unquote has been oppressing you.
Okay, so then just say that. But y'all going back and forth. Just say that. She made her point. You could debunk it by saying that. Just say that. Get over.
Okay, I'm just asking questions. I'm sorry.
I think we have a responsibility to the listeners, though. When she brings up the compromise of 1877, her point leans towards the Democrats. But what I was saying was that if her point leads towards the Democrats, then that's factually inaccurate, because black people did not support Democrats back then. They supported Republicans, and Republicans were the ones that so their points kind of nullify each other. So it's inaccurate to even bring that up as a point in regards to what we're talking about right now.
Can I say this real quick? You and I both know that the Democrats were prevalent in the southern states. They were the slaveholding states. Let's be honest here. Why do we lie, bro?
I never said they weren't.
You're telling me, but you were telling me about betrayals.
That is a betrayal, because.
But why would you vote for the very same party that betrayed your?
Because the party changed, and you know that it changed.
No, it did not change. It's always been the same. Huh?
Okay.
Answer your question. When did it change? Because Martin Luther King up until 68 was a Republican. So when did it change for black people?
You knew that it changed when the Civil Rights Act was signed, and they began to give black people rights, and they started to migrate to inner cities, and they saw that majority of the Democrats changed their way of thinking as far as coming on board with progressing the Ro, black.
Are you a Democrat, Ro? You're not even a Democrat, right?
I'm not. That's why I'm just saying, I don't even know why he's even going back and forth with me.
But bro, you voted for a Democratic.
As an independent, I'm able to vote as
a Democrat. Thought he was the best candidate, is what you're saying.
I thought he was the best candidate. It had nothing to do with me agreeing totally with Democrats and whatever it is that they're doing. I'm actually a conservative socially, but I also believe that we need to home in some things. So yes, I do.
You're a conservative socially.
I am an independent. I am.
Ma'am, how can you be you said you're conservative.
I can't be a conservative, a social conservative. I can't believe that somebody that needs assistance can get assistance, but they need to be on it for the rest of their life.
Therefore, you are aware conservatives don't believe in socialism.
See, that's the problem. You guys put these narratives out here, and that's not necessarily true. I can be a social conservative and say I believe in assisting people, but not for the rest of their life.
So you're a conservative who believes in the welfare state?
I'm not going to go.
No, this is a good dialogue. I'm asking you a question.
No, it's fucking terrible dialogue, actually.
Who believes in the welfare state?
I do feel a little bored.
No, seriously, bro. Are you a conservative? Believe in the world? Because you said you're a social conservative, right?
Independent who believes that people need assistance. They get assistance. They don't need to be on it for the rest of their life.
Yeah. So you're willing to pay for that assistance as a conservative, as a hardworking person.
I am, but not for the rest of their life.
Okay. I'm just asking the question. I'm just going about what you're.
And we out.
Thank you guys so much.